This is Bunyip Bites. Fairyland. Dim veils and shadowy floods, and cloudy-looking woods, whose form we can't discover for the tears that drip all over. Huge moons there wax and wane, again, 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 every moment of the night, forever changing places, and they put out the starlight with the breath from their pale faces. About 12 by the moon dial, one more filmy than the rest, a kind which, upon trial, they have found to be the best, comes down, still down, and down with its center on the crown of a mountain's eminence. While its wide circumference in easy drapery falls over hamlets, over halls, wherever they may be, or the strange woods, or the sea. Over spirits on the wing, over every drowsy thing, and buries them up quite in a labyrinth of light. And then how deep, oh deep, is the passion of their sleep. In the morning they arise, and their moony covering is soaring in the skies, with the tempest as they toss like almost anything, or a yellow albatross. They use that moon no more for the same end as before, but illicit attent, which I think extravagant. Its atomies, however, into a shower dissever, of which those butterflies of earth who seek the skies and so come down again, never contented things, have brought a specimen upon their quivering wings. Edgar Allan Poe, 1831.